United That's a relief. I risk. Congratulations! You can continue playing. Sure, lad. The High Necromancer toiled at the Mana Tower for several years, significantly improving life-prolonging spells. Now, for only a fraction of the cost in mana crystals, people could triple their lifespan. The military was the first to benefit from the spell, greatly enhancing the kingdom's power. The High Necromancer, having access to many mana crystals, was guaranteed to live for centuries, as he believed a true genius should. For his contributions to the kingdom, the High Necromancer was awarded a position on the High Council. However, the high consumption of mana crystals at the Mana Tower attracted a constant presence of crimson mist, prompting people to migrate, leaving Deadwoods populated only by the military, mana crystal miners, and undead. Over many decades, the Kingdom of Undarion grew strong and prosperous. But with increased life expectancy came overpopulation, leading to the need for more territory, and ultimately resulting in long and terrible wars. In their extended lives, people sought entertainment, making gladiator games even more popular and profitable, leading to your guild's prosperity. Blood sports flourish in this type of environment and time. And that's how it went with the High Neck. You did, standing on the side. Anyway, listen. It was an enormous pleasure working. For the end, I wanted to show you some statistics that...